On this week's episode of American Airgunner, we'll be sitting down at the round table. We're joined by Blue Book of Airguns Steve Fjestad to discuss the amazing history of airguns. Rick Eutsler will be reviewing the Umarex Octane, and Jim Chapman is in Arizona hunting the rarely seen javelina. All this coming up right now on American Airgunner. All right, we're back here at the round table to discuss some good old-fashioned air guns. I'm here with, of course, the godfather, Jim Chapman, and we'd like to welcome Mr. Steve Fjestad to the table. Sir, how are you doing?
Thank you, good.
Welcome.
Glad
to
be here.
Guys, let's break it down. We're talking the history of air guns. We've got a bunch of books, magazines that have been written. Some of them, looks like, a long time ago. When did people first start writing books on air guns?
Not that long ago, Rossi. Actually, this is one of the early ones, from 1907.
1907. You're right, not that long ago.
It might be 1909. I may have misspoke. This is one of the early ones from 1909. But it was about one gun, the BSA. The BSA was the first modern air rifle. Mm-hmm. And it so revolutionized air gunning, or shooting even, in England, that the man wrote a book about it. King George actually introduced them into his army for target practice.
Okay, and what do we consider a modern air gun?
Well, a modern air gun has several things. Number one, it's rifle barrel. Two, it's reliable. Some of the older air guns were kind of flimsy, even though they look like they're stoutly made. Number three, it's built along modern lines. Some of the older air guns don't kind of look like rifles at all. They look odd to our modern eyes.
So this is obviously over 100 years old, and now looking at what kind of has become the Bible of air guns over here, the Blue Book of Air Guns, Steve, which you have written and published and putting out, this is like the 10th edition?
Yeah, that's correct. That's the 10th
edition. How did it go from this little guy to this big guy?
Well, actually, I rode on top of a lot of backs in this industry. Tom is, you know, you're right, he's the godfather. He started, as far as I'm concerned, he started the popularity of the modern air gun, really got it going, and I think through his efforts, advanced the technology, got people interested in it, reported about the history. Here's one of his publications I was talking to you earlier, Tom. What year was this?
Probably 96.
I was fascinated by this stuff because I was an air gunner myself, and there weren't any really books about the entire field, especially new ones, and I was getting calls with the Blue Book of Gun Values. Steve, what's this air gun? What do I have here? I got a Steyr. You know, what is this thing? So I go, why don't I just put it in the gun book for a while and see where this goes?
Yeah.
Well, it got bigger and bigger. Then in 2001, we came out with the first edition of the Blue Book of Air Guns, 6x9. And from the humble little start, it's grown into the monster on steroids, the 10th edition, and we're working on the 11th edition right now, which is going to be over 700 pages.
Goodness gracious. When are we putting this thing online?
It is online.
Okay, good, good, because somebody hit me with one of these not too long ago, and I'm still
it's a lethal weapon.
You're right about the history of the Air Gun Review. When I first moved back to the States, and I was seriously into air gunning, and they had a couple magazines back in the UK that I was reading, because, you know, I mean, they've had the air gun trend going for a lot longer there. But when I got here, there wasn't much reading material, and I started looking at the Air Gun Review and also Beeman's catalog. You know, that was the thing. That was like the Christmas catalog.
Right.
I could sit for hours looking through that.
Now, was that more of a shopping catalog, or was that about specific guns?
It was kind of a unique combination of the two. I mean, it was a catalog where you could buy, but he had a lot of articles. Tom wrote a lot of those articles.
Stuff.
Uh-huh. Yeah, right,
yeah.
Right.
It was wonderful. That's how we all learned.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more from the round table. American Air Gunner is sponsored by Umarex, Zeroed In, Pyramid Air, America's largest retailer of air guns, and by HotSign, serious, solid impact.
The pistols you've watched in action for generations and the ones you've always wanted to own are now within your reach. Introducing Umarex Action Pistols. These high-quality replica pistols, powered by CO2, look, shoot, and feel just like a powder burner. Plus, ammo is economical and always available. Umarex Action Pistols. From the past, present, and shooting into the future.
Octane The Umarex Octane features tremendous velocity with a quiet downrange noise thanks to the integrated silence air noise dampening system. Powered by the ReAxis gas piston that provides more punch, more power, and more speed. These two technologies combined deliver a smooth, accurate shot with maximum power. The Umarex Octane.
PyramidAir.com. Let's see.
That was fast.
Bingo.
Honey, did you do those chores yet?
Chores?
Roger, put that drink down. We gotta mow. Chop, chop.
Oh, yeah. He's out there showing the grass he's boss.
Pyramid Air. Big selection, fast shipping, the air gun experts.
Welcome back to the round table, as we are continuing our discussion about the history of air guns.
When you first started writing about air guns, what was the point? What message were you trying to get there? Why did you start writing about air guns?
It wasn't a message, Rossi. It was a strange thing. I had a subscription to an American air gun magazine. It was one of those low density magazines, only goes out to 1,000 people or so.
Sure.
And right in the middle of the subscription, the thing folded. And I was without my magazine, and I screamed and yelled, and my wife said, "Why don't you write a magazine?"
Classic wife.
I don't know anything about air guns. And she said, "Sit down and write out the titles of the articles you could write." 3 legal sheets later, I had over 90 titles, and we started the Airgun Letter, which was my newsletter in 1994.
That's a collector's item these days, by the way.
Is it really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, goes
like
for,
Benjamin
yeah.
Franklin's old letters. Yeah,
big money on eBay.
Hey, by the way, you guys, you're missing something on Beeman, though, okay?
Yeah.
What was on the inside page, last cover, back cover of every air gun catalog that they ever put out? "We'll buy your old air gun $10 to $40. And that was the intake mechanism for Dr. Beeman's air gun collection.
Is that where it came from?
Sure. And he bought them cheap. Nobody was buying stuff for $400 or $500.
Actually, he wouldn't give you cash. He'd give you credit off on a sale.
On a trade. For a new gun.
Those guns were $200 or $300 at that time as well. I mean, they were pretty expensive air guns.
And he's getting them for $10 to $40. So how big's his collection now?
It's huge. It's 4,000. Probably the largest in the world.
4,000 guns.
Yeah, I've been there, and you can't get them in 8 rooms.
Wow, and he's got them from what, like the very early?
Oh, he's got unique guns, doesn't he? I mean, they go back to the European guns, 200, 300 years.
He's got them everything up to 1986. That's where he stopped. That's when he sold Beeman. And but he's got Ghirardonis. He's got Austrian sniper rifles.
He's the man who gave the Ghirardoni rifle that Lewis and Clark carried to the U.S. Army. He donated it, and that's a over-$1 million rifle.
So what's that collection worth now?
You know what? He would be one of the few people on the planet who would know. And I wouldn't want to try to buy it from him.
Yeah.
That's why this book is so wonderful, because it gives us a starting point. The numbers in here are always a little bit off from what you find in reality, but that's going to be true of anything.
Sure.
Any shopper's guide. But they give you a starting point. You know whether the thing is rare or not. You know what kind of condition it needs to be in, what kind of finish it used to have. All of that's in here. That's what this man has done for our community.
But I've had a lot of help along the way. I mean, Beeman helped me out tremendously. It's not just a pricing guide either, Ross. There's a lot of history in that book that we felt was important. I mean, why is an RWS, why is a fine work bow, why is an early Crossman Daisy worth that kind of money? Well, if you bring up the history and get people interested in the history, now you have a potential collector base.
Right. See, I've found this to be very, very close in terms of what the values of the guns I've looked at. The only thing that I think is difficult to capture are these guns that build up a fast cult following. You know, we all see it. There are these guns that are built, and the day after you get the gun, you can sell it for twice what you paid for it.
Okay, so let me ask this. Starting with you, Steve, what's the oldest gun that you've actually put your eyes on?
Ghirardoni.
Yeah?
Austrian, from Vienna, absolutely.
What year?
1775, 76, something like that.
Wow.
Only because Beeman had his collection on display, some of his collection. Interesting guy, and he started the air gun business, but without Tom over here, and what he's done, and his tenacity, to keep going and keeping us all educated. There's only one guy at the SHOT Show that I asked to walk around and inform me of what's new and what's hot and what's not. That's that gentleman right there.
All right, Steve, I'm going to let you get his autograph later.
Guys, I'm going to have to cut this off. You guys have way more information than we can handle in this segment. If you want any more information about air guns, the history of air guns, where you can find the Blue Book of air guns, or maybe we can get the Godfather's old letters, maybe, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. We'll be right back. Guys, I mean, you two, enough with your encyclopedia knowledge, and then you throw this guy.
All right, guys, after the break, we'll see what Rick Eutsler has to say about the Umarex Octane. Stick around.
Quiet Energy, a new line of PCP air guns from Hotsun USA. Available in 177, 22, and 25 calibers. The Quiet Energy line of air guns is perfect for serious target practice as well as small to medium-sized game hunting. The new Quiet Energy series delivers more usable shots per fill and puts more energy downrange while keeping the noise levels to minimum. If you're looking for power and accuracy in a quiet air gun, your search is over with the Quiet Energy line of PCP air guns from Hotsun USA. Life can be loud, but sometimes silence is golden. Introducing the Umarex Fusion Air Rifle with a combination of CO2 power, the Silence Air 5 chamber noise dampener, and a precision rifled barrel. The Fusion is a bona fide tech driver that's the quietest air rifle you'll ever own. Experience silence with the Umarex Fusion at umarexusa.com/FusionTV.
Airgun Web with Rick Eutsler to do a little gun review at what I like to call Air Gunner's Paradise. This place has absolutely everything.
Absolutely.
Rick, how are we doing today?
Doing very well. How are you?
I'm doing good. So I see here we're looking at the Umarex Octane.
Correct.
How long have you had it, and have you had a chance to put it through the ringer?
I've had it for a while. Got it through the break-in period, and it's, I tell you, from the time I took it out of the box, it was shooting almost dead on.
So. Really? How many shots does it take typically to get it through the break-in period?
Well, each gun's going to be different. I say a minimum of 250.
How do you know? Does it like ding?
It just smooths out.
Okay.
I mean, it cocks a little smoother, the trigger pulls a little better. It'll just settle out. Now, if you have a chronograph, you'll know when it breaks in, because when you first get it, you're gonna have a high variance. One will be real fast, one will be real slow. And as it breaks in, that'll start to tighten up. And when you get it real consistent, then you know it's broken in.
Why don't we kick off things with just aesthetically? What are your favorites?
Well, it's very cool looking.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I really like about the stock, and they did a really good job with this, is that for those that like the thumb hole grip, I'm not a fan of it personally, but you've got it. But if you're more traditional, it actually works really well just running your thumb right up the back.
Okay.
That's how I would normally shoot. It's not uncomfortable. And you know, most thumb hole grips, it's either thumb hole or nothing.
Sure.
But this is actually really nice. So if you're if you like a more traditional feel, this works great.
Okay.
Aesthetically, it's great. I don't know what else to say. You don't have a hollow sound at all. They've got a great trigger.
Mm-hmm.
They've got the Silence Air system up front for the
right.
suppressor, so it's super quiet. They put a Weaver rail on here so your scope won't ever slip. They've included decent rings, and the scope's actually a really good optic. And one of the features you have, which is very unique and nice to find, is you have what's called an adjustable objective. So you get your gun out and you're gonna shoot something close, and you zoom all the way in, all of a sudden it's real fuzzy.
Mm-hmm.
You can actually set your range here so you have full use of the magnification and it always stays in focus.
Okay, so I can see here, so it's marked 10, mm-hmm. 15, 20, looks like all the way up to, wow, 300 yards and
yeah,
infinity.
And
there's literally an infinity.
To infinity and beyond.
There's
right.
an infinity mark right there. While you were putting this thing through the ringer, did you find anything that surprised you about the gun?
Absolutely. This is what I'm gonna call a super magnum. So it's really at that upper edge of the power level.
Mm-hmm.
Usually in a super magnum, you're gonna get dieseling when you first get it. That's the lubrication, the initial lubrication kind of burning off. It's very loud and messy and not a lot of fun during that break-in period.
Right.
You get a lot of recoil with a Super Magnum and it's just difficult to shoot. I didn't have any of that with this.
Really?
I was really, really impressed with just how well it shot out of the box. I threw the scope on it and I was only an inch off. Now, I can't guarantee that's going to be the case for everybody, but you know, it was just a joy to take out of the box, set it up, and have no drama. And even the trigger was very good. I was just very, very impressed.
Let's go put it to the test, shall we?
Sounds like a plan. You want to grab it?
Yeah. So we've heard all the specifics about this gun. One thing I'm anxious to see is the silence, how quiet it is.
Here we go.
The Umarex Octane. And here we go. Now these are great American air gunner targets. They have you. There's the little ones on the side, there's the big one, there's a lot of different places you can go with it.
I call this my shop multi-shot target because there's lots of targets on it.
Okay.
It's very quiet.
I mean, that sounds completely different than it did inside.
Yeah, it's very, very quiet. And I'm using a trap that is a silent pellet trap, so you don't get the impact out there either.
I mean, if you're looking for a gun, may I?
Absolutely.
If you're looking for a gun, like you talked about, that if it's obviously legal, but you want to shoot in your backyard to not annoy your neighbors or make them think you're shooting a rifle out here, this is definitely the gun.
Right.
That is nice. You know, people are always asking me, you know, what's the best air gun for this? What's the best air gun for that? And it typically comes down to, what can I shoot?
Yeah, what can I kill?
What can I knock down targets, kill varmints if I'm having a problem, and not be the guy that looks like that you can hear and it sounds annoying to your neighbors.
Right.
And I mean, I gotta tell you, this is...
And that's a very high-powered rifle.
It really is.
It's very, very quiet.
The Umarex Octane, great gun. If you want more about Rick's basic rundown of this gun, you can check out his links for Airgun Web at AmericanAirgunner.com. Rick, always a pleasure.
Absolutely.
Thanks, man.
Great
and I gotta
you.
Tell you, I might go spend the weekend in your garage.
You're always welcome.
Thanks, man.
When American Air Gunner returns, we'll be tagging along with Jim Chapman. He's in Arizona this week, looking to take down a javelina. We'll be right back.
All right, it's time for our American Air Gunner trivia, brought to you this year by our friends at Blue Book Publications.
A legend in innovation and tradition. These classical and modern masterpieces have sent pellets downrange for over three decades. German engineered to last a lifetime. Quality, power, precision. RWS, the world's finest air rifles.
This week on American Air Gunner, we're on our way up into the mountains in Arizona, up above Phoenix, to do a javelina hunt. This is an animal I've been wanting to hunt for so long, I can't even tell you. We're on our way up right now to the mining town. We stopped, we're gonna do a little bit of shooting here. And I wanna tell you about the gun I'm gonna be using. This is the Even X. It's the Sniper, it's a 357 caliber, so a 35 caliber air gun. It's a little different in that it shoots pellets, Diabolo style pellets. So it's like the pellet you used in your 177 and 22 on steroids. It's a big pellet, weighs over 77 grains. This gun puts out about 130 foot-pound. It's very accurate. I had it out the other day. I was shooting at 50 yards, which is the range I'm gonna go to. I could stretch out to 90 yards on this, but 50 is where I'd like to take the shot if I can get it. But if I have to go out further, I can. It's a side lever, 7-shot, uses a rotary magazine. Now this is a very tactical looking gun. I've used the same action in a more traditional styled rifle in Africa, and it really did well for me. And usually I like the more traditional look, but I've got to say, this gun has really been growing on me. It's bare bones, so it looks like it's not maybe going to be as ergonomic as you would think, but this gun comes up so well, has an adjustable stock, set to pull. This gun handles so well. It has a four stock, which is just this grip piece, which is mounted on a Picatinny rail, so you can move it up and down, get it adjusted just perfectly. But I really like this gun. It's gonna be great to get out there. I'm here in Globe, Arizona. We're on the javelina hunt this week, and this town's amazing. It was found back in the 1870s. It's still, mining is the lifeblood of the city. And it's nestled into the Sonoran Desert right up north of Lake Roosevelt. And it's just surrounded by this beautiful desert landscape. Saguaro cactus, rock formations, everything you want to see in a desert. This is a lot of fun. We're heading out to get that javelina. Come along, we're gonna have a good time. I'm out here with my buddy Kip Rowe. He's a guide. He's an air gun expert as well. It's unusual to get those two together. Kip is bringing me on a hunt I've been waiting to do for a long, long time. This is the first season in the U.S. where it's legal to take javelina with an air gun. And Kip's already done it. He was out there last week.
Yeah.
Beat me to it. But I got my tag and I'm ready to go. I'm so pumped for this.
It's going to be fun. We've been out here a lot. We've been back here in these hills watching these pigs. There's a couple herds we've been watching. I think we got a pretty good chance. It's just rough and rocky and noisy.
It's
so getting in with an air gun shot's gonna be fun, but we can do it.
It's a rough territory. There's a lot of hills, a lot of rocks, a lot of shale up through here, and getting up in the cactus. All right, let's get going.
Let's get it. We got this next saddle, and the pigs are right on the east side.
Okay.
One boar started coming this way, and he turned and went back. So we're going to ease up here. We might see something kind of spread out pretty far.
Okay.
So we're going to be alert and ready. Hopefully, we'll get over here and around to where we can get them coming on.
I'm starting back over the ridge.
Yeah. Okay. Hopefully, we'll get to them where we can get them coming to us.
Okay.
Stalking them in these rocks is just tough.
Ready to go. Let's do it.
He's gonna come right through there. He's gonna come right there. Right there. It's about 85 yards. Done. Got your air gun javelina.
Finally. So excited I'm running through cactus.
Yeah.
Ooh, I got an aroma.
Yeah, a little bit.
I've been after that for so long.
Fantastic.
You know, Texas, you can't hunt them.
Yeah.
And I've had so many walk by my scope, and I'm just going, oh, someday.
Some nice pictures of him. Good pig. Probably a boar. It's pretty good size. No, that's a big old sow.
Wow. In terms of size, this is a good size.
This is a fantastic pig. This is an average representative animal. It's a big sow. It's pretty big, you know, for a sow. Everybody talks about bigger pigs. A lot of times you'll see a pig come in maybe in the, you know, 50-pound range, 60-pound.
Are they pretty vocal?
I mean, they're very vocal. When the herd gets split up, they're very vocal. And when you get into a bigger herd like that and you bust them out, if you're hiking or somebody gets a shot and misses and you blow them out, a lot of times you get a varmint call and you do real quick little bleats on it and they'll come running in. It's a really fun animal to hunt. It's one of my favorite.
Right.
You do a lot more glassing than you do walking. You know, you sit down, you use your glasses, and today you know, my partner and buddy, Steve Sullivan, you know, he was sitting up there on that bluff with the radio and the glasses. You know, we work real well together, and without him this morning sitting up there, this wouldn't have happened.
Why don't we get this back, we'll go get some late breakfast.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
Start the pack out.
That's it.
Next week on American Air Gunner, we'll be back in Arizona for the 2013 Shoot Right Air Gun Expo. Then, we travel over to Kansas, where Steve Kreiner is hunting something a little less dangerous. We'll review the Sam Yang Sumatra, and I'll have my very first challenger of the year. We'll see you next week.